In this video, we're going to show you how to use PageSpeed Insights. What PageSpeed Insights is, it's a Google application for website performance. And Google has put a real big emphasis on PageSpeed. So no longer can you just, I guess, put up a website, put up any website, and the page is not loading fast. So if the page is loading slow, it's going to affect your rankings in Google. And so they've done a great job with PageSpeed Insights. And, you know, I'm going to show you how you can use it for your website so your website can perform at an optimal level. So right here, you should enter your website. So the website I'm going to use is a website that I always use to create websites, to show different tutorials, to show how to build a website. Actually, it's a domain that I use when I do other videos. So how to create our website. And so what you want to do is just press that analyze button. And as you can see, what it shows you about the how your website is viewed on mobile, also how it's viewed on desktop. And that's another emphasis that Google has really, really stepped their game up in. Your website has to be a responsive website or a mobile optimized website, because of, you know, there's a lot of traffic on the mobile with all the different phones everywhere all across the world. So not only just here in the US, but all across the world, people are using telephones at all time rate and using just different mobile devices, not only phones but tablets as well. So right here it tells you what the problem is and it shows you how to fix it. So this here, reduce server response time. If you click here, it'll tell you in our test your server responded in 1.5 seconds. There are many factors that can slow down your server response time, and you know, they try to help you out as much as they can. Also, the browser caching. So if you are not a web developer or you don't have any, I guess, insight about how to develop websites, this may be a little difficult for you. So you might want to just pass the video along, maybe to the person or the team that you have that's putting together your website. So it shows you how to fix the leverage caching and setting an expiry date or a maximum age in the headers, instructs the browsers to load, so on and so forth. As you can see here, issue with tag manager, also an issue with some Facebook code, with a tag manager code, Facebook code, and some other code, the Google Analytics code as well. Now, well, I'll get into what I was about to say in just a second. Optimize images also. So it's good to have a pretty good plugin if you're using a WordPress site, to have a pretty good plugin like auto optimize, where you can auto optimize, you can optimize your images, and you can fix this pretty easy. Now these other two here, me personally, through my experience, well, you probably have to Google setting an expired date, because that's a whole nother thing as well. But this stuff here, I wouldn't particularly worry about. I would worry about this more so than anything. Also, optimizations found, I guess that's good. So downloaded optimized image JavaScript CSS resources for this page. What's crazy about this also is if you enter your website, I wouldn't test it only one time. I would test it at different times of the day. And I also would test it multiple times throughout the day as well, because sometimes this here will change. So if it's at 78, but maybe I don't get most of the traffic on my website at this particular or at another particular time, but maybe I get most of the traffic on my website right now. And, you know, it's prompting me to fix this. On the desktop side, see, there's two sides to it. So pretty much shows you almost the same thing, but I still would go in and see right here. It's telling you, or it's telling us, your server responded in 0.77 seconds. There are many factors that can slow. So it's pretty much the same thing that it's saying. So right here, optimize images. Let me see if it has the same images. Yeah, pretty much the same thing. Let's fix that. Okay. Scroll down here. Yeah, and the same. Optimizations are found. So that check mark button lets you know that's fine. You don't need to worry about any of that. But right here is similar. Needs work possible. Yeah, but I didn't see anything about setting an expiry date. Or did I just completely miss that? Yeah, I didn't. Even if you fix one side, like focus on this side, because that's giving you a green check mark and it's giving you your score, I still would just focus on this side. Even if you have some things wrong on this side, you know, you can fix them if you like, but it'll probably, you know, just take you a little more time. But this one here won't be hard to fix at all. Let's run it again. Let's just see what it does again. Sometimes it'll pass it. See, like that time it passed it. So, actually before I actually checked it last night and I got the same scores of 85 here, and it was like 87 on the desktop, but now it's showing 89 on the desktop and 85 right here. But it's still a good thing to fix some of this stuff, especially things like optimizing the image. Now you may have to go, may have to either go on a file manager and upload a expiry date. And if you don't know how to do that, or if you're game to do it, you know, you can always Google anything you get in here. You don't know exactly how to fix it, just simply go to Google, do a Google search on it and see what you can find, or look it up in YouTube and see what you can find as well. So there's always a video here in YouTube to show you how to fix certain things. And like I said, right here, this I know exactly what this is, because I know the code that I put on this particular website. So this is just code that I have. There's the Google Tag Manager, some code that I have for Google Tags on this particular website. And I know I have code of the Facebook pixel on the website as well. So and some code for Google Analytics for a plugin that I have on the website as well. So using PageSpeed tools, the PageSpeed Insights tool, it can really, really help your website performance, regardless of when you're watching this video or what year you're watching this video, whether it's 2017 through 2018, 2019, it really doesn't matter. But when you use this website, the great thing, and I'm kind of glad that they built this, because it tells you, you know, what's wrong with your website. So how can you speed the pages up when someone is on your website and scrolling through your content, getting information about, you know, any possible products or services that you, you know, may or may not offer. So this is a great tool. So yeah, PageSpeed Insights website performance. So how to use PageSpeed Insights website performance 2017, 2018, 2019, 2020. It doesn't matter what year, but this shows you exactly how to use PageSpeed Insights. So thanks for watching this video. Hope you guys learned something. Hope I brought some sort of value to you or actually helped you fix your website loading problems. Thanks for watching this video, and we will see you in the next video. Thank you.